If, yeah, you tell me, you did watch a match. If you did watch the match, alright, first, if you never watch a match, you don't miss nothing at all. To be completely honest. And if you did watch it, you don't miss. If you blink, you don't miss it. Because the match done fast. Just like that, match over. Right there, sir? Throughout the match, did one-sided. You almost feel like Curtly Ambrose is a prophet. The man said, well, you know, sir, Chris Gill is not an automatic pick for the team. And when we take it, when we take a closer look on it, nobody on the team never ready. For the match of it, to be honest, never ready. It's a very good side, you know. Don't get me wrong, you know, you talk about some hard hitters, you know. Not necessarily the best bowling team in the world, but one of the best striking team. You talk about Chris Gill, like some of the old legend them. Chris Gill, Dwayne Bravo, Andre Russell, Pollard. You still have Simmons. What man is him? Them line up from 1 all the way to 8. Just them are a top batsman. Well known. Them have the capability to put on any size total and chase down any size total. But today, them not do nothing at all. Let me tell you exactly what they do. They lose all of them ricket for under 60 runs in a less than 15 over. With Chris Gayle of all people scoring 13 runs, right? So the man them all out for 55 or 50, yeah, 55 runs. If you see a day when Chris Gayle score 55 runs, yeah, it's like, yeah, John Oster, I'm have a bad day. The entire team score 55 runs. And Gayle top score with 13 out of the 55 runs. So him alone make about quarter of the runs by himself. And him no make nothing. The team no go on with nothing at all. And you know what happened to? The man take a catch. Chris Gayle take a catch. So as bad as it look, a Chris Gayle outperform everybody else. Right? The man make the most runs and take a catch. John, and that this enough to say him go on good. Can go on, you know, go on good. But if you look on him strike rate, it's 100%. The man strike rate is 100%. He faced 13 ball and him score 13 runs and him hit 3-4. So you know say typically in our 2020 strike rate supposed to be all 300, 400. And them they are good strike rate. 100 and a good strike rate. Because if a man spend 50 ball, face 50 ball and make 50 runs, he literally waste the whole ball him. So Chris Gayle strike rate and never nothing. It was not a good strike rate. But when you look on the team, and when you look on the controversy where they surround the team, leading up to the World Cup cricket, leading up to the to where them dead right now, everybody, all eyes on Chris Gayle. And him go out there, and would I say, yo, him humiliate himself. But the fact say him humiliate himself and do better than everybody else. Whoa. What a team. What a team. West Indies, on paper, top team, gladiator man. I tell you, say, the man them capable of making 300 runs in a 20 over. That are the kind of team West Indies have. They have a batting team. And if them not go on with nothing as a batting team, with the bat, it's all over. If them go on with something with the bat, then you know, say, them bowler can defend a thing or two and them feeling can, you know, them once they represent with the bat, it's all over for the next team. And for some strange reason, you know, so the West Indies team have a history of chasing much better than when them set runs. Yeah, them chase down a total much, much better than when them set a total. So if we see the West Indies team going for bat second, we can almost say the chances of them winning is over 50%. When them going about first, the chances of them winning is under 50%. So yeah, go look on that too. It's like right now when you look on it, the West Indies team, them literally lose. Them lose the match. But them lose the match fast. We could have almost say the result could have been the same either way. You play 20 over, but 20 over, say 150 runs. You just take longer to lose. The writing did depend on the wall. Again, once Chris Gayle go out and dominate, then you know say, it boosts the morale of the batting team, which is the West Indies team. But if him underperform and him losing wicket early, it boosts the morale of the opposing team, which is the bowling team. And the West Indies team morale just drop. Pollard go out, no go on, morale drop. Andre Russell go out, no go on, morale drop. If the other man them do something, no matter how much them put on, nobody no really care yet, you know. until Chris Gayle come and go. And them stays and them assess where the match go. Because the thing about them man is why them cause so much controversy and bring so much attention. Because them a superstar. Every team need one. So, no matter how you look on it right now, if Chris Gayle go there and make 0 runs, the superstar is there. He bring a certain amount of anxiety and thrill just with him presence. So you have to give it up to a Chris Gayle, no matter how you look on it. World Cup and a World Cup without Chris Gayle. No care how you slice it. It's like a Usain Bolt. If Usain Bolt show up in the arena, we know what we expect. Even if him goes and pull out, no matter how fast the next man run and win, once him dead, him bring that feel good vibes. The same thing with Chris Gayle. But may I tell you, the West Indies, he don't look good. He don't look good. I say right now, on paper, I want the best team. No questions asked. But not in terms of bowling, but just batting. Good team, very very good team, and the world know it. Everybody around the world, I watch Chris Gayle name come up. Everybody want to see a warm. So me can tell us right now, him do the best. Not one of the worst performance of West Indies ever have. And anyhow, West Indies have the best performance ever. Very very likely, say a Chris Gayle go do the best. But the man them still feel like so they can win. Them still feel like so they can bring home the trophy. A two of them gone out of six. And them are the winningest. ICC 2020 World Cup team. Yeah, so we still have a lot to look forward to. We still have a lot more. And you're gonna get the update them, yeah, so, and the breakdown. And what you say, Curtly Ambrose, you have to say what you have to say. And I'm whole of people share the same sentiments. And who know where I watch? Talk it out. Who know if he's a man no good? Until him go on good. And when him go on good, then we say, alright, you know, say boy, we always believe in a girl, you know. But you say, once him not go on good, we know him no good. But I just saw things said, especially if you come from Jamaica, we are bound to fire upon him. And when him go on good, I will pride and joy. I just saw the thing work. This time around, England, why? I wonder if then they go down to the church of Montegobia. Wonder if then they go down to the church of Montegobia. Because for them voodoo drunk, then go on good. Wanna feel? Wanna feel? Talk to me. Drop a comment downstairs and just subscribe, man. Get me to the 1,000 views so that we can go live. I would know the thing, you know. I just reason about the thing, but me need a subscriber. You see me? Rewrite the narrative.